It's another beautiful Friday in the Spice Country, and well, it's the start of the weekend, and I'm excited. I'm also excited to be hosting yet another program, Bonje, and it's live on GIS TV, produced by the Grenada Cultural Foundation. And Bonje happens every Friday evening from 8 to 9, right here on GIS TV. So those of you who are joining us out there, if you're hanging by the bars, if you're sitting within the comfort of your homes, wherever you are now, we want to say welcome and thank you for tuning into GIS TV for the program, Bonje. Now, Bonje takes us down a trip looking at our culture, the personalities who were involved, and culture is not just about the performing arts. So you want to highlight our food and our sayings and every aspect of our culture will be highlighted on Bonje, that program right here on GIS TV. Well, we now will start with some Bonje news. Now remember, this is Bonje, so hey, Bonje, there's a wreath-laying ceremony at Fort George. This Saturday, October 19th, it begins at 4:30 p.m. Right? So don't you forget, remember the events of October 19th and so. There'll be a wreath-laying ceremony at Fort George. You may want to go check it out. There's also a national school quiz takes place on the 22nd of October at the GBSS Auditorium. That you also would want to take a look at Saturday, October 22nd, sorry. And Bonje, the National Celebrations Committee hosting a Thanksgiving church service. This time is Friday, October 25th. St. John's Anglican Church, and that happens in St. John. Yeah, let's spread the activity. We have some in St. George's, now we go to St. John's, and that begins at 10 a.m. And there'll also be a wreath-laying ceremony, and this time it's at the monument at Point Saline's and St. George's, and that begins at 3:30 p.m. Now that too happens on Friday, October 25th. Right, and Kariku Launch, Carnival Launch, Saturday, October 26, 2013. Yeah. This year. And there's Fish Friday happening even right now as we speak. Now, if you like your fish and go up to Guelph, get some sumptuous fish, boy. That'll be good. And of course, there's a lot of fry bakes. I like the fry bakes too. Right? And Diwali Festival on November 9th at Spice Basket. So that's your Bonje info. All this happening right here in Spice Country. Right now, we'll take a break, and when we come back, we'll be having a nice chat with somebody who you'll be happy to meet.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
The National Celebrations Committee invites all to celebrate Thanksgiving on October the 25th, celebrating 30 years of peace and stability. All are invited to attend the church service at the St. John's Anglican Church on St. Peter Street in Guelph, St. John. The church service starts at 10 a.m. Come out and celebrate peace and stability. Get involved in community activities and celebrate with a family in the afternoon. Plan games, picnics, sports, and more. Let this Thanksgiving be truly about giving thanks and praise for 30 years of peace and stability.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
Welcome back. We're live on Bonje, and we have in the studio with us this evening Dr. Malachi Dottin. Yeah, I had a problem with the name there. Dr. Dottin, welcome to Bonje.
Great being here. How are you doing?
Bonje, went to the doc, you look good, man. Now, we know you were recently involved in the World Food Day program, that big extravaganza that highlighted our food. Tell us what's the focus behind this, really.
The World Food Day activity, which took place on the 16th of October, it's the celebration of an activity which have started by the World Food Organization, FAO. Mm-hmm. And as a country, we have looked at it and we have adopted a theme which is sustainable food system to ensure that we can guarantee food security and nutrition for the population.
Good. I like the idea of food security because, you know, there's a concern around the world now that you must be able to be sustainable. Every country should be able to be sustainable. And I remember a lot of years ago by there was this slogan, grow what you eat and eat what you grow. How does that actually influence this particular activity?
surely we would have taken the decision to ask ourselves, do we have a sustainable food system?
What's the answer to that?
What ingredients is needed within that system?
Okay.
How do we go from here to there? Who are on the buses? And we have concluded that we need to assess and examine our system to guarantee that the population on a whole have four milestones that could be guaranteed. So what we would have done is that we would have come up with what we refer to as a Zero Hunger Challenge Initiative with five objectives. Based on the time of the program, I will just go through some of it. We are saying that within 4 years, we want to guarantee that Grenadians have access to a sustainable food system. But even most importantly, that within that 4 years, we can increase farmers' income and productivity by 100%. We can ensure zero waste within the agriculture system. But importantly, we want to guarantee that Grenadians have access to a complete food security system. And we are saying that to do that, we need an actionable framework with complementary intervention and collaboration to maximize the all stakeholders' input. So we are trying, and we want to start from a result, not actually working towards a result, but working from a result. So we are saying that consultation will take place, and we involve from the village level, the community level, and coming up to the nation. We want to guarantee that the non-governmental organization can participate in that discussion. The government have taken a deliberate policy decision, and that policy decision has to be, cannot achieve without the village intervention.
Okay, Doc, let me ask you. You speak about the government involved, being involved, and that's good, at least with respect, let's say, policy guidance and so. You speak about other parties, but I'm thinking the farmers, because obviously if we speak food, we must speak agriculture, and if we speak agriculture, you're speaking farming. Is the message really getting to the farmers, and are they on board? I mean, you speak about farmers, the plan to raise their income by 100%. That sounds good. That sounds like music to my ears. But are the farmers really involved?
Yes, the farmers will be involved. The farmers presently are involved in the different aspect of farming. We are seeing, based on some new intervention, we are convinced that their production and income will be increased by 100%. How will we do that?
Okay, and before you go into that, Doc, how would you do that? I like that. How would you get younger persons involved in farming? Because one of the challenges that we have is that the average age of farmers in Grenada is over 50 years. How do you encourage the younger people to get involved in farming and to bring their input to bear to this whole drive?
The government have taken a deliberate policy decision to establish what we refer to as a land bank. And that land bank policy is to ensure that the lands that are not worked make it workable. So we will identify lands that are not used, lands that are not cultivated. And working with FAO, we are coming up with a program whereby those lands that are not cultivated, that people are not using, we will have consultation with the owners and guarantee that the land can be leased, but even most importantly, if some of the lands has to be bought, it will be bought, and guarantee that the youths can utilize those lands.
Okay.
So the land, that land bank will be crucial in ensuring that lands are available to the public.
Okay, good.
Before, if you move, where do you live?
I live in St. Patrick's.
In St. Patrick's, you'll realize that there are a lot of lands that are not cultivated.
That's correct. That's correct.
And most of the people, some of them do not live here.
That too is correct. Now,
so how do we address that?
Well, obviously, I think when you mentioned the whole issue of in some cases, I guess, acquisition, purchase of land, you know, government acquisition, that is certainly some of the ways to address it. Let's shift our attention a bit, though, to the activities on the 16th. I understand there was a wide array of Grenadian foods on display. I mean, and although I wasn't there, regrettably, but I had a taste of bread nut, man. Well curried and I mean when I heard that, I thought there was meat, all kind of meat involved in that. What other foods did you have on display?
Well, I want to focus that in terms of the Zero Hunger Project, mm-hmm. because within the Zero Hunger Project, there will be what we refer to as a multimedia campaign: eat what you grow and grow what you eat.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We would have known about that. Adage some years ago.
Oh yeah, a long time ago. There was also the buy local campaign.
Precisely. So what we'll be trying to do is to guarantee that not only we promote fruits and vegetables, utilization of fruits and vegetables, but also manufactured product.
Mm-hmm.
Because we are saying that if you need to solve the problem which is existing in Grenada, you need to increase production. You need to increase activities.
Mm-hmm.
But importantly, by doing that, you'll increase consumption. Thus, you'll be able to lessen in terms of the input bill, which is crucial.
Especially in this time.
Especially in this time. So most of the produce,
mm-hmm.
and product that you would have seen during the World Food Day is because we are saying that the only way, one of the ways to move the economy, we need to move in and increase our production, increase activities, increase consumption, eat what you grow and grow what you eat.
And increase the income for the farmers.
Increase the income for the farmers. But we ought to be able to see the Zero Hunger Project, not only the farmers. We will not be able to achieve Zero Hunger within 4 years without the involvement of a broader domain,
mm-hmm.
the health sector. How would we achieve eliminating hunger amongst 20 children less than 5 years old? Mm-hmm. So the Ministry of Health has to be involved. And one of the most important thing in terms of eliminating hunger and saying that buy, grow what you eat and eat what you grow, is starting with the school children. Okay. So the Ministry of Education also ought to be on board.
Mm-hmm.
So it's multi-dimensional in terms of the sector. All the sector will have to be involved.
And on that note, Doc, I want to really thank you. I mean, on a topic like that, food security, we could go on and on and on.
Very much so.
But given the time constraints we have, mm-hmm. I really want to thank you for coming to the program and sharing with us, you know, the whole rationale behind the World Food Day celebration, but also focusing on the Zero Hunger Initiative. I really particularly like that part of it. Now, you're live on Bungie, and Bungie, I didn't realize all this time gone already. We're going to take a break right now, and when we come back, we're going to take you down an exciting activity that is certainly going to make you scream, Bungie!
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
The National Celebrations Committee invites all to celebrate Thanksgiving on October the 25th, celebrating 30 years of peace and stability. All are invited to attend the church service at the St. John's Anglican Church on St. Peter Street in Gore, St. John. The church service starts at 10 a.m. Come out and celebrate peace and stability. Get involved in community activities and celebrate with a family in the afternoon. Plan games, picnics, sports, and more. Let this Thanksgiving be truly about giving thanks and praise for 30 years of peace and stability.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
Welcome back to Bungie. And remember, we were just chatting with Dr. Malachi Dutton, always have a little problem with that name of the rider. But now, just before we go to that exciting activity that I told you about, that is certainly going to make you say, Bungie, we want to get the PSP persons who are outside and listen to the program involved. There's a call-in section now where you can call 435-2636. That's the number you want to call. And here's the question we wanted to answer. What did you do before there was Wii One? What did you do before there was Wii One? No, I know the answers to that. The responses could be varied, and we are really eager to hear those responses. What did you do before there was Wii One? The number once again, 435-2636. Now I'm picturing here by myself, my grandmother coming down the road before there was Wii One. And I mean, I really can't say what just went through my mind, but I also remember a story about Macme Pentad. Macme Pentad was a lady in the forest with one grain of hair. We seem to be getting a call. Macme Pentad had one grain of hair, but if that call is for the program now, we'll tell you about Macme Pentad when we get back. So hello, good evening. Right, so Macme Pentad with her one grain of hair. No, that call is somebody who's calling to the program. Hello, good evening. Welcome to Bungie.
Good evening.
How are you, my dear?
Fine, thank you.
So you calling to join the program to tell us, what did you do before there was Weave On?
What do I do before there was Weave On?
Yes, darling, let's hear you.
I wash my hair. And I would take ironing comb.
Ironing comb?
The ironing comb. And put the ironing comb and press your hair.
Well, hold on. Ironing comb, what was that?
What
was ironing comb?
Ironing comb is something that you put on the coal pot, or you put on your stove and heat it. It's a hot comb. And you press your hair.
But that must have been work,
But if it's raining, sometimes you don't do it because you catch a cold.
Okay.
After that, you wash your hair, you grease your hair, and you corkscrew it.
What's my professional expression? You what?
You corkscrew.
How you did that?
You twist it along. I'm looking at you,
Bungie!
You twist the hair along. It's a little knot like the little African hair. So that's what we used to use long time.
And so tell me now, so when you organize your hair like that, you put your little corkscrew and things, so how you so set it?
You set it, that's how you go out.
So that's how you...
some lime and everything.
But I get the feeling that, I mean, you had to start to... If you prepare your hair to go out, you had to start seeing about 4 o'clock if you're going to have a 7 o'clock lime.
No, man. You wash the hair. You put your grease in it. And then you take your finger, you twist it in two, and then you corkscrew it around. You used to call it corkscrew. I don't really mean now. And you get it well set up. Some persons would have done that. I used to do that. And then sometimes if I have to go to other function, I let it go. And it looked like a little jerry curl kind of thing.
Nice. And when you step out, you're hot.
A hot as fire.
Thank you for calling. We appreciate your input.
You're welcome.
Bungie. You hear things more before? I mean, here you're going to make a lime. You had to wash the hair, get an ironing comb. And I'm certain that some of the younger folks may not be aware of what an ironing comb was. But I grew up with my grandmother. Well, not all the time, but I used to be going on vacation by my grandmother, and I know I saw ironing comb, so I could identify what the lady was speaking about. But the lines are still open, 435-2636. We want to get another caller. Tell us, what did you do before there was Weave On? I mean, nowadays you just sew on your weaver and you organize yourself and you're hot. But of course, people before was well presented too, and they presented yourself nice, they organized it here, so obviously they had a method. And we just heard from our dear friend there, what did she do? So give us a call, tell us, what did you do before there was Weave On? Now remember, you're looking live at the program Bungie, and Bungie comes to you every Friday between 8 and 9. It's a program produced by the Grenada Cultural Foundation. And Bungie is intended to take us down or a memory lane, if you want to call it that. Take a look at persons who were instrumental in helping develop the culture. I mean, not only speaking, as I like to highlight, not only speaking about the entertainment and performing arts, but culture in its broadest sense. Like, you understand this lady here with her, what did you do before there was Weave On? That was part of our culture, right? How did people look nice? How did they dress up before? All right? So I'm your host, Robert White. Remember, the number is 435-2636. Give us a shout. Tell us, What was like life like? What did you do before there was Weave On? Okay, so we're going to take a break right now. And when we come back, remember, I keep telling you about this exciting activity. I'm just beside myself with excitement. I had a look at it and say, Bon Jovi, but we'll be right back.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
The National Celebrations Committee invites all to celebrate Thanksgiving on October the 25th, celebrating 30 years of peace and stability. All are invited to attend the church service at the St. John's Anglican Church on St. Peter's Street in Gore, St. John. The church service starts at 10 a.m. Come out and celebrate peace and stability. Get involved in community activities and celebrate with a family in the afternoon. Plan games, picnics, sports, and more. Let this Thanksgiving be truly about giving thanks and praise for 30 years.
Years of peace and stability. Years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
Welcome back to Bon Jovi. Now, as we indicated before the break, we're taking you out to a bungee moment. I mean, that activity that is just designed to make you bungee. Take a look.
Bungee.
She pettiness, more. She wants to know when the mother get mad. Say they want climb on the hedge in a quad. She lift up the scoop and a bugs on the road. Then over touch the floor, girl, wine get mad.
Bungee.
Bon Jovi, you notice what just happened there? We don't want you to repeat that at home. Please. Now, this was just for entertainment. I mean, this was Mr. Rum taking a drink. You notice what happened? He drank almost a bottle and then take a little sip of Coke behind it. We don't want you ever be doing that at home. But so that was our Bon Jovi moment. I mean, the first time I saw that video, I just cracked up. I was beside myself with laughter. I couldn't imagine that somebody could be so daring. But there are people out there who just make you go, Bon Jovi. So.
She pettiness, more. She wants in a plan.
When the mother get mad, say they want climb on the hedge in a quad. She lift up the scoop and a bugs on the road. Then over touch the floor, girl, wine get mad.
Right, so we now take you to our video moment segment, and that is where we highlight one of our videos, I mean, local or otherwise. And today we are happy to present this beautiful video to you. Just sit back, relax, and take a look.
Summertime, come on. In the Isle of Spice.
Let's go. Spice Island, come on.
Summertime, come on. To the Isle of Spice.
Let's go. Ha.
Buckle up, take that trip to Grenada for the summertime. Yes, man. Pay a mass, drink some rum, smell some spice, and free up your mind.
You know, see how we do.
A gem in the Caribbean, so unique.
Feel fantastic.
Sceneries to sweep you off your feet.
Feel fantastic.
Friendliest people you'll ever meet. With food and calypso music. The time of your life is surely guaranteed. And we got ladies, sexy ladies, gorgeous ladies. Yes, they all so fine. Yes, man. Fat boom boom, tight zoom zoom. Good waistline, oh how they could whine. See a summer body in a tight outfit.
Looking fantastic.
In the club stage show at Fifth or the beach.
Looking fantastic.
Spiciest women you'll ever meet. There ain't no doubt about it. Can't resist my Grenadian babies. When it's summertime, come on. To the Isle of Spice.
Yeah. Spice Island,
come on. Summertime, come on. To the Isle of Spice.
Let's go.
Festival over, this chica from Venezuela say she want to stay.
Yeah, what you tell me?
No quiero salir, por favor, puedo quedarme.
Ha.
Yo
Plus one dip in the sulfur spring.
Feeling fantastic.
Plus the jab stick that give her the sting.
Feeling fantastic.
Made this the island of her dreams. She love me ice cold and green. Say she want a Grenadian puppy when it's summer time. Come on, ha. To the Isle of Spice. Let's go. Summer time. Come on, to the Isle of Spice. Let's go.
Why you say expert?
Summer time.
Unique kind of mass.
Isle of Spice.
Spice Island. Summer.
Summer time.
Summertime. Bonje, well, I was just enjoying myself. I didn't realize the camera's back. Welcome back to Bonje, and that video you're looking at is a video from a young man who really, really impresses me. He's from Carriacou, Grenada, Carriacou, and P.D. Martinique. Yeah, he's from Carriacou. And he's actually the son of a renowned Calypsonian. We don't hear much of his days, but really did give us some bumper hits as well, Skylark. And that was Fimba. What's Shotpre? What's his Fimba something? I can't remember now. But that's Shotpre. And what I really like about Shotpre is that he has found his groove. I remember when he just started, he sounded pretty much like another artist. I wouldn't necessarily call him. But he has now found his groove, and he has certainly been making waves, not just locally, but regionally and internationally. That tune was one that would have earned him the Groovy Monarch title. It might have been last year, yeah? And he came back even impressive this year again. So that was our video moment highlighting the works and the talents of our local boy, Shotpre. Yeah, Shotpre. We're back in the studio. With us here, we have a gentleman who has made his name as far as the music is concerned in Grenada, specifically on the oil drum. No, not this drum. That is a goatskin drum. But this man has made his name on the oil drum. And I'm told that he's been in the steel band movement from since he was, why should I say that, boy? That's a long time ago. And I'm born, gee, I wonder if I should. Since he was tiny, so about a dozen and change. Let's welcome Mr. Hood, Tiloti. No, I'm trying to remember. Harold Pice, they sang a song one time. He had a hook line. Tiloti, toto, pow. Welcome to the studios.
Yes, sir.
And welcome to Bonje. Now, I mean, look at you. I ain't seen nothing new that say Pan, but everybody tells me, I mean, you have been involved in Pan from since there was a little boy. Tell us what it has been like for you.
Well, I enjoyed it from the beginning, and I could still be in it now.
You still play Pan?
No, my Pan at home.
We still play your Pan at home?
Yeah.
Okay, so I mean every night before you go and sleep and kind of thing?
Yeah, according to the tutor coming over the TV or the radio, take a play.
How long did you really start playing Pan? I mean, and what got you involved?
Well, to say what got me involved, well, it's just the Pan, you know, that got me involved. Uh-huh. Because in the early days of steel band, you're not supposed to play that.
What do you mean you're not supposed to be that? Pan has a distinction of being the only musical instrument that was found, right? In the 20th century, that's what I'm told.
Yeah.
So what do you mean you're not supposed to play Pan?
Well, it's a bad thing to do that. It's a criminal act.
Oh yeah?
You never hear the tune, if your daughter friend with a steel band man, what the mother would do?
So steel band men are considered to be what? Renegades in those days?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
For instance, when I see band at the practice, you know Daddy Bo in Bergman?
Yeah.
The park they had to go. And the police will still turn up. The police will still turn up to run you off.
I mean, Bonje. Police used to run you when you play in band?
Yeah. You ever see a band go up Cooper Hill? Run up Cooper Hill.
With a pan on the back?
From police, yeah. You know,
tell us, what would have caused the police to be such against the whole Pan movement in those days? Was it the people who were involved, or that the music was just not appreciated?
I think the music was not appreciated. Steel band, you know, they come like nothing.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and if they feel that long as you're in the steel band, you are no good, or maybe something like that.
Oh, okay.
So police had to come in.
But obviously you persevered, that didn't stop you.
The first Pan I make, my mommy took it. and put it on a big stone in the yard and take another big stone and no pan in the band. No pan in the band.
But that time she was playing pan too, innit? Just with instead of a stick, she played a stone.
Exactly so. She played always a stone. you understand?
But obviously you persevered. And I'm certain there must have been a time when the steel band started to get some kind of acceptance. Because today, I mean, the steel band is playing in church, it's playing in parade, it's playing everything. So there must have been a time when that accepted. What would have really influenced that acceptance?
Well, just probably that just had to come about it. Because, you know, I don't know. The people change.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, change.
Yeah.
A fact of life. Change.
Yeah, change.
Who are the persons you start playing pan with? Who are some of these folks around and identify any of them?
The first steel band I played in is a band they called Bandits.
No, we know why.
Bandits.
If you come out with a pan named Bandits, I mean, say something. So, Tiloto, you all had a wrong choice and name to start with.
Well, Harmonites.
What about Harmonites?
Harmonites come after.
Okay.
They come after. But Bandits, the band. We go in the States 6 times.
In the U.S.?
Yeah.
So are you suggesting there was more acceptance for the music in the U.S. than there was local?
Well, you had to be that.
Uh-huh.
6 times. You know I used to play cricket for Grenada?
No, I didn't know that. But I thought it was only pan you play?
No, actually.
So you play pan, you play cricket, you didn't play the full, no?
Nah.
Okay, good. Just checking.
So I was playing cricket in Dominica for Grenada in 1960.
Mm-hmm.
And the telephone... Cable.
Well, I almost thought you said your cell phone. Eh? I'm going to say bonjour. Well, I mean, it's
cable. Real. States in 6 days. Come home. That's the band who here.
Yeah.
Mr. Bristol was one of the boss men of the two.
That's who, Carl Bristol?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I showed him the cable. And he said, Dirty, take it easy. We'll be back home on time. And as soon as I reach back in the States, it's steel band. 6 years we played, going for 6 months, 5 months.
And that long? These are long tours, man.
Yes.
Yeah.
Long tours.
You must have made a lot of money in those days, Tilo.
Well, very good.
Yeah. I'm just trying to find out if the steel band man earned his keep in those days in terms of the recognition, in terms of financial rewards through recognition.
Well, where you get the attitude, maybe. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You can't demand anything like that.
What are some of the cities you toured playing steel band?
No, we just went to New Hampshire. New Hampshire Highway Hotel.
Uh-huh.
This is it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you kind of like a resident band for a 6 month kind of period.
Yeah, 6 months period. That was it.
How would you compare the music though? Steel band music, the steel band movement on a whole, back then as against what's happening now?
Well, now it's advanced stage, you know. Now it's, you know what I mean? In them early days, can't compare to now. For instance, I played with Three Sticks.
Three Sticks?
Yes.
You did?
Yeah, well, so I could play now.
Even now you play Three Sticks?
Yes.
Which hands you use the two?
This sticks? Is the two. This is the one. So three notes make the chord. So you go for it.
And so that helps with harmony, I guess.
Yeah, man.
Uh-huh.
The first time I see a Three Sticks is it. One of the pantunas from Trinidad,
mm-hmm.
where I suppose you are the best in the world of us.
Mm-hmm.
And he come up to tune some pan for me when we bring in this tuner. And we sit down chatting. And he put on a tape there.
Uh-huh.
And while he's in, there's more than one person supposed to be playing.
Right.
So I said, that's more time. He tell me, nah, man. He that playing. I said, you go fool me with that? You are playing it? He said, when I finish making the pan, you'll see. So when he finished making the pan and I see he do that, I say I have to learn again.
Yeah. You had to play with that Three Sticks as well.
Yeah.
I am told that you were involved for a long time with the River Road steel band.
Yeah.
All right. How many years of service you pan actually
Wizards?
Did? Pan Wizards.
Yeah. Pan Wizards from 89 to now.
So you're still...
25 years next year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You actually founded that band?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm told that there was a band that you started when you were young with 20 something, Breakaway or
Wayside Symphony.
I tell you the names cause people to be upset. Wayside Symphony.
Yeah.
Were the Rebels or
Pan Wizards? No. Which one you mean now?
The first one you gave the first name.
Bandits.
Bandits. I mean, so yeah. Obviously the change in name might have brought about the change in acceptance. I have a feeling that's what it was. Right?
I know. Yeah, but I bought Pan Wizards.
Uh-huh.
You see, Pan Wizards, the band Pan Wizards come from City Symphony.
Okay. So that was another band you was involved with as well?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
When it pick and in turn and thing, everybody, Don Philip, Joe. So when the band separated, like the men,
yeah,
we have Riverwood Men and Tom Men.
As you mentioned, men. Mm-hmm. In the early days, did you have women involved in Span, or is that a recent phenomenon?
Well, the woman is more than one.
So you still have like one woman.
Thank you.
But I mean, were they actually actively involved with playing the Span, or were they like backup support?
No, Happy Hill had the first Happy Hill band,
uh-huh,
had the first ladies playing.
Oh, Happy Hill.
I have a thing with that Happy Hill band, you know.
Yeah.
The fella that used to tune and thing. Nowadays, this is only foreign tuners. Only.
You tune?
If I tune?
Yeah.
We all get band.
Oh, okay. So you have your own. I always wonder about the whole art of tuning. I mean, obviously, I didn't expect you to give me a crash course in tuning.
Read and understand what I'm saying.
These men should be for the early working steel band in Grenada. All right.
Yeah.
And
see those names?
Daddy Bull, Bot Marichaux, who is Swabby, Will and Harris and Doc and Tiloti and so. Oh, pan tuners. So all these people are pan tuners.
Yeah, well, they're coming here to make no pan.
Doc Steele.
You know Doc Steele?
No, I've seen the name
here. Mm-hmm. Right. University man.
So, I mean, these are people who were involved in the steel pan movement and Grenadians who were tuning pan. How is it that we don't have our own pan tuners these days? What happened?
This is a story. A band bringing, St. Paul bringing the first foreign tuner, uh-huh. St. Paul's band.
And since I've heard, everybody follows suit. Well, we have a thing in Grenada where we believe that. Once it's foreign, it's better than local.
Yeah.
But you were here doing this, so, I mean, did you teach anybody? Did the fellas hang around to learn?
They didn't learn as such.
Yeah.
You might have one man controlling a band and tuning and finding this thing. But nowadays, these days, we need pan tuners because those Trinidadians come in and go with all we money.
Right.
You understand?
And even apart from the money part, I mean, the money is important too.
Yeah.
The money stays here. But I believe in terms of, if you want the art form to grow and develop, you must have people who are involved in and be able to contribute in every aspect of the art
form. Every aspect of it.
So, you could play nice and everything, but if you can't tune a pan. I mean, yeah. Imagine I come down and make a quattro. And I ching, 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 and you out of tune and everything.
Yeah, you have no. You know what I mean?
Pretty much the same thing for the pan man.
Yeah, we missing that badly. We need.
So how do you think that we can turn around that?
Well, you had to start with the Steel Band Association. Mm-hmm. Somebody had to put this thing forward and work mm-hmm. on it from there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But nothing is happening. Mm-hmm. Nothing.
So the association not as active as it should be then? Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And sorry to say it, but the president of the Steel Band Association, man,
real trouble. He ain't presiding.
No. Real trouble, man. This here is on it.
Yeah.
This one here.
Uh-huh.
For instance, the last festival we had was 1976, the last steel band festival.
Yeah, you're right. That's
could you
that.
Imagine that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Panama. You know, from 1976,
I'm
your president of Steel Band Association.
All right, we need to take a little break at this time. Mm-hmm. So we were chatting here with Tiloti, a well-renowned pan player, pan tuner, you heard it from himself, And still play Span every night before he goes to bed. when we come back, we continue with more live action on Bungie.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
The National Celebrations Committee invites all to celebrate Thanksgiving on October the 25th, celebrating 30 years of peace and stability. All are invited to attend the church service at the St. John's Anglican Church on St. Peter's Street in Gore, St. John. The church service starts at 10 a.m. Come out and celebrate peace and stability. Get involved in community activities and celebrate with a family in the afternoon. Plan games, picnics, sports, and more. Let this Thanksgiving be truly about giving thanks and praise for 30 years of peace and stability.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
Welcome back. As you notice, we still have Tiloti here with us on the set. I'm so excited because I was just enjoying the conversation. Right? Tiloti, before the break, we were speaking about the whole fan movement and some of the deficiencies that you see. But let's focus a bit now on the making of a pan. I mean, I've always wondered, you take a high drum, what do you do first? What do you do after? How do you get to this?
According to the pan you're making. You sink the suit.
Right? So first you must sink it?
Yes.
Why are you using to sink it?
Hammer. Big hammer.
And just keep punging it?
Really? Not just keep punging it, you have to know where you're punging it.
Okay.
Yeah. You pong, you sink it.
I figure when I was trying to make another pan, when you take it to the pong.
See no pan in the band. You sink your big hammer, your mark out. And these days, a pan of 28 and thing notes and thing.
Yeah.
But long ago, you ignore internet as such, you make a pan with 10, 12 notes.
Yeah.
What you call, do re mi fa sol la ti do.
That was all you had?
Yeah.
So now you have things like minors and so then?
Well, you have sharps and flats now.
Sharps and flats?
Yeah.
Okay.
You understand? The pan tuning, you know, chromatic.
Oh, chromatic scale, yeah.
C sharp, D, you know?
Uh-huh.
So completing the Bolongo, you just put 8 notes.
And that was it?
And yeah.
Oh, okay, and okay.
Until it started to develop. You know what I mean?
How do you get, because I see the little circles and some of the circles I notice are smaller and some are bigger.
Yeah. Higher
notes are smaller circles?
Yeah.
Ah boy, I ain't so stupid as I look. Punji, I good.
Long ago, you was ignorant of the size of the notes, you know. To take a C note, a low C note, there's a special size for that.
Right.
And then if you end up in trouble, yeah. I've seen a man stop play pan, because when you start to get the knowledge of what's going on, so this note is too small to take that note.
Uh-huh.
This too small, the note you want to put it.
Yeah, the space size, too small.
Yes. Uh-huh. So move it from day to day, and that was
you're confusing.
That was the end of the man. That is no joking. the man is that Tinky Lopez. I don't know if you know him.
No.
Yeah, that's one of them. Moving one note caused him to done play Steve.
Yeah. Well, you're confusing, yeah. Mantilo.
Yeah.
Tell me something though. There's the as we indicated, there are women playing steel band now, and we notice as well that there are steel bands in schools. Mm-hmm. And even outside the school arena, there are some bands that actually have a junior side.
Yeah.
Right? How well do you think that is influencing the growth of steel band?
Well, I think it's been good, you know, to have the kids coming up. In the early time, kids can't play steel band, you know?
No. They get flogged on the ritual, they come up with a steel band.
Yeah, crazy.
And they come up with a pan, big stone, right?
Yeah. So these days, you know, a real development.
Tell me something though. Sometimes you have a family, eh? and you know, you see other people taking after one another, and so. Did you have any of your children follow your footsteps as far as playing pan?
I only have one child, and it's a girl. She never played.
She never played. She was one girl I make the band by.
Yeah. But no, my sister kids, which is 6 or 7 of them, everybody play.
Well, of course, I know somebody had to take the thing.
Yeah, everybody. Mm-hmm. Well, the panos was just behind the house, right?
Yeah.
The band. West Side Symphony is home in the yard.
Right.
So all the kids.
Good.
I don't know if you know Brian Hood.
Brian Hood? Mm-hmm. Yeah, man.
You know him?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you have a classic with that, you know.
Yeah.
A man sit down right in my veranda and tell me what go on with Brian in the States.
Uh-huh.
He go to the panels, kind of, what the thing coming on. So he go to the panels,
uh-huh,
and he take a play on a pan.
Mm-hmm.
And them fellas in the panels, he had some Grenadians. They say, where you come from? He say, Grenada?
Yeah.
What part of Grenada? He say, River Road. So, if you come from River Road, you know Tiloti? So he, just as though he will
laugh. Yeah, he laugh too.
He said, they laugh because Tiloti is the uncle.
They know, can I question they ask it?
Yeah. Tiloti is the uncle.
Right.
One time he joined the band. The fellow tell him that right in the veranda.
If your uncle named Tiloti, you're most good. Yeah.
See, you come from River Road. But if you come from River Road, you know Tiloti. See, you start to laugh. Oh, Tiloti is my uncle. One time in the band.
What are some of your best years, your most memorable years in steel band?
City Symphony win.
Panorama?
Yeah, three times.
Yeah.
75, 76,
mm-hmm,
77, the band went on tour,
yeah,
so we didn't take part in Panama. That's 77.
Right.
78, win. I first say that is not a trick, because you skip 77.
Yeah, skip 77.
But 81, 82, 83.
Yeah, well, you show them that
is a real thing. That is a real thing.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Tiloti, you just have me really excited speaking about the pan here. I mean, it's unfortunate that we constrained for time.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to thank you so much for coming on the program,
yeah,
and sharing your experiences, your insight into the steel band movement. And we want to thank you, too, for the contribution that you have made. All right. Hold on the piece of paper, boy. Are you local tablet?
Yeah. Yeah. One of the things I wanted to say, like the president of us, of Steel Band Association.
Let's do it quickly.
The president of Steel Band Association in Grenada should not be a player, should not be involved in no band. And this is what's going on here.
Oh, because you want him to be unbiased.
Yeah.
Right. I get the point.
And the past pantuners, they must pay attention to that.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Acknowledge they were wrong. But again, but that's about it.
Good. We want to thank you so much again. Tiloti has been a profound
pleasure.
There
could be a next time.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. We know where to find you.
Yeah.
But this time you come in your panda. We want to hear. We want to see. Don't move here. See on the street. But we want to see you play with the three six. Yeah.
We'll play 3-6, man.
Woo! Having a chat there with Tiloti, I mean, one of our ace pan arrangers. He has been involved in the pan music. Yeah, as you heard it for himself. But right now we. I can't help but laugh about Tiloti more than the pan, you know what I mean? But we want to feature one of our icons, our cultural icons, Mr. William Elcock, a.k.a. Scaramouche, Scaraboy. And we're going to take a break, but when we come back, we're going to drop Scar on you, man.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
The National Celebrations Committee invites all to celebrate Thanksgiving on October the 25th, celebrating 30 years of peace and stability. All are invited to attend the church service at the St. John's Anglican Church on St. Peter's Street in Gore, St. John. The church service starts at 10 a.m. Come out and celebrate peace and stability. Get involved in community activities and celebrate with a family in the afternoon. Plan games, picnics, sports, and more. Let this Thanksgiving be truly about giving thanks and praise for 30 years.
Years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
Welcome back to Bonje. As promised before we took the break, We want to feature at this time one of our cultural icons, as we try to do on every program. We actually feature someone who has done well, who has made a significant contribution to the art form. And this evening, the spotlight falls on William Elcock Scaramouche. Let's take a look.
Music, we sing, on the sound I love to hear. Music, hey, on the reggae, let him hear. Get him a voice. Not on your face. The following day after, yes, about 12:30, Austin, Good and Phyllis calling from the battleship. Change your clothes, change back to civilian. Like Uncle Sam, take over my island. I hear music, what you say? Uncle Sam, I love to hear music. Uncle Reagan, let him hear. Get him a man. I remember you. Go!
Pop, 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 pop. Now, let me tell you something. Some of you may not remember that song because it happened quite a while now. But that song was a big hit in Grenada because it was timely. And the pop, 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 pop resonated well with some of us who are wrong for the intervention. And the helicopters passing in the air, yeah? Helicopters passing. This song they were playing. Pop, 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 pop. Remember that so well. That was our icon, the Scaramouche, William Elcock. And today it was indeed a pleasure to go back to the days when Scaramouche would have actually did that song and to connect with the intervention and the events thereof. Speaking of the intervention, remember October 19. But before we tell you some more about that, we have another guest in the studio here. You know, Squeezy had a song, Miss Mary had some fine young ladies. Well, we have one fine young ladies here. Donovan, welcome. Welcome to Ponche.
Thank you.
How are you? It's good to have you on this. Really
I'm
good to have you on this.
I'm prepared for this.
Your stomach is yours. Good. Do what you want with it. You could take it out too.
I put on my lose weight swimsuit.
Relax. I have a belly. It's detachable. I'll leave it home before I come down.
You won't give me a secret. Could you imagine laughing? Dainty. Yeah. With your stomach in. I'm doing it.
Now, we were told that you're just back from Carico.
Yes.
Right? And there was a judges workshop stroke seminar in Carico. I mean, how was that?
It was very, very good. Mm-hmm. It was an event that was coordinated through Grenada Cultural Foundation, Carico's Carnival Committee, mm-hmm. and Digicel. Digicel has been a partner with Carico for quite some time.
Right, for the carnival, and the carnival activities.
Yes, for the carnival activities. And they continue to lend their support in any way they can to the continued development of Carico's Carnival product.
Mm-hmm.
This workshop was a long time coming. It was a request from the Carico Carnivals Committee coming out of last year's activities. They felt that there was a need for persons within the art form, be it artists and judges, to have a better appreciation, a better understanding of what it is that they do, understand the process.
Mm-hmm.
And as such, we were asked to assist with facilitating a workshop that assists with meeting their needs.
How long was the workshop? Over a couple of days?
No, it was one day.
A one-day workshop?
Yes, it was from approximately 10:30 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
Scheduled to have finished at 2. Because it was so intense. So I want to say user-friendly.
Yeah.
That
yeah.
persons didn't leave there until after 3 in the evening.
Okay.
Yeah, that's very, good. Very interactive. It was well attended for Karaku, of course.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it was really, really good.
Who are your facilitators?
Gemma Jordan out of Trinidad
uh-huh.
and Aylan Robinson from Grenada.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Good old Aylan, who has been given human service. I don't know the name. I don't know the name Gemma Jordan, but at this time we want to take a break, and when we come back, we'll continue with our conversations.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
The National Celebrations Committee invites all to celebrate Thanksgiving on October the 25th, celebrating 30 years of peace and stability. All are invited to attend the church service at the St. John's Anglican Church on St. Peter Street in Gore, St. John. The church service starts at 10 a.m. Come out and celebrate peace and stability. Get involved in community activities and celebrate with a family in the afternoon. Plan games, picnics, sports, and more. Let this Thanksgiving be truly about giving thanks and praise for 30 years of peace and stability.
30 years of peace and stability, bringing families together.
Welcome back to Bungie, and just before the break we were speaking, and we're still fortunate to have in the studios with us Donna Lynn, and she was giving us an insight into her trip to Karaku for that judges workshop that took place. And tell us again, the facilitators were?
Gemma Jordan.
From Trinidad, right?
Yes. She brings a wealth of institutional knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
She has taken part in numerous competitions. And on the stage, she speaks to a judging. She has a background in vocals. She's very, very knowledgeable. She does a lot of radio work for some of the local radios in Trinidad, a lot of MCing as well.
Mm-hmm.
So she has been around for quite a while. And then we have our own Aylan Robinson. He was very, very instrumental in assisting us with putting the packages together mm-hmm. by way of giving back to Karaku. Again, he comes with a wealth of institutional knowledge. Aylan brings with him not just Grenada, a Grenada feel, but a regional feel, because he has been around, you know, listening to a lot of the music. And one of the things that I must say that really helped the artists and the potential judges to understand the process was that they incorporated into the workshop a bit of songs, music.
Mm-hmm.
While it was primarily music of Trinidad, because obviously that's where the facilitator is from,
mm-hmm.
but it allowed us to understand better, to have a better appreciation for what it is that we listen to. You know, she incorporated some of Sparrow's songs while she was describing, you know, the way in which you should, the explaining the criteria with the melody, the lyrics, the, mm-hmm. the stage presentation. You know, songs were used to better explain what it is was, you know, she wanted to say.
Okay.
So persons had a better understanding of what it is she was delivering.
So they got a theory, and she would have actually said, well, here's a song that that explains, but, you know, that is strong in this area or is strong in that area.
Yes.
What was the response? I mean, you said earlier on that the folks were really happy, that they were it was intense and they appreciated it. But what were the comments that you got afterwards from the persons who attended?
They understood.
Mm-hmm.
It was not a case where you handed them a criteria, or on the night of the event, the MC goes on stage and he says, okay, folks, the judge is looking for lyrics, 20 points, stage presentation, 40 points, crowd response, 5 points.
Mm-hmm.
It was not that. It was more than that. It went beyond that. They understood what you meant when you say lyrics. They understood what you meant when you say rendition,
mm-hmm.
when you said presentation, lyrical content. All of those things were included mm-hmm. in a detailed explanation was given, again, using songs to draw out, you know, what was taking place, you know. So it was timely.
Mm-hmm.
It was really timely, especially with the fact that there were a number of persons coming out of Karaku who entered the final stage of competition, you know. So
this year. Yeah, because we have seen, I mean, over the years, there have been an increase in the persons from Karaku.
Yes.
And I think that's really good. good from the standpoint that the Karakunians get a chance to actually show us their skill and show off their skill on a bigger stage than their own.
Yes.
Unfortunately, we don't have as much time as we want to. Where you was all the time? You should have come and sit down with me all yard.
You didn't want me next to you.
She good to be born, yeah. So, this is yet another program. It is the end, unfortunately, of another exciting program, Bungie on GIS TV. And the program, as we indicated earlier on, is produced by the Grenada Cultural Foundation. Until next week, when we come back here, Friday, 8 to 9. Have a great weekend. Love you.
My brother used to...